today we're recording a track I wrote back in the 90s. It's called Closed Circle. And the idea of the closed circle is it's where the spiritual and material world unite. It was a dedication to the spirit of Stephen Lawrence, who was brutally murdered in a racist attack in Eltham. And I remembered writing this track and playing this track for his mother at the anti-racist festival in Greenwich. I think for British history, it was such an important time, you know, so it was not just about a negative outcome. It was about using this to actually move forward as a society, as a nation, and you know, really put out those positive energies and really celebrate his life. When Lex came to me and he said, I really want to do this track, I initially thought, well, you know, we've done it. Why do I need to do it again? But then I thought to myself, actually, things go in cycles. And so it's that thing of sometimes revisiting something, you can actually bring out some other gems and some other beauty. And so I thought it would be lovely to do it differently. So we took the tempo up, added a lot more kind of hard hitting. So the band is Indigo, and the idea of the Indigo at the time when we were gigging and recording, that lineup wasn't really so prevalent in the London scene. You know, the idea of no harmony, no guitar, no piano. Baritone saxophone, trumpet, drums, and bass, acoustic bass. So it's almost like, you know, Italian food. You've got very basic ingredients, but when they're put in the right combination and the right proportion, it's magic. So we've got Tony Kofi on baritone saxophone. I've known him over 25 years. And, you know, we grew up together, practicing together, learning together, hanging out at gigs and studying together. So it's really a natural situation to work with him in any situation. And then Tom Skinner, the wizard of the drums. When he was started with Indigo, he was 18. Just to see the way that he's blossomed and you know, formed his own groups and is an inspiration. On bass, we've got Keelan, and he's done a great job on this. When I first heard him and I was judging the semi-finals of the BBC Young Musician of the Year, Jazz Musician of the Year. And I was really struck by his love of the music, but also the way he danced with the music. And he really brings that to the track. It's always important to work with people that you feel comfortable with. And I think the music is so much more than the notes and the dots. It's what the musicians bring to the music. It's that situation also of knowing people around you and really trusting everyone around you and knowing that the music will be what it needs to be. But I think Blue Note for me has always been the pinnacle of jazz, and all the artists that were on there, Art Blakey, Lee Morgan, Freddie Hubbard, Donald Byrd, you know, it's like the legacy, Herbie Hancock, the legacy of music on that label has always been an inspiration. So being on a Blue Note album is a real honor, and it's something that is part of our legacy.